This one is not your average grandfather's slip joint. What's going on, everyone? Back with another episode of Stuff and Things. Lockdown Knife Week is continuing on, and we're going to jump right into the hashtag because it's happened again now for the second time in a row. We have this photo right here coming from Grimwald NG, and he has the exact knife that we're taking a look at today. He also has it stacked up on some crazy wallet there. I'm personally a Travax diehard, but that's just me. So it's super cool to see that some of you guys out there who are using the hashtag also have similar knife interests as myself. Now, this is a style of knife that I was never really interested in. However, once I got one knife made by this manufacturer, I knew that I was kind of hooked. And then the more research I did, I found out that this thing came out, and I realized that I don't really have any good slip joints in my collection. This one really spoke to me, and I decided to pick it up. So without further ado, today we're taking a look at the Chris Reeves Impinda. The Impinda is a William Harsey design that was brought to life by Chris Reeves Knives, of course. Their vision was to make a modern slip joint knife, and that is exactly how I would describe this thing to people. It has super sleek lines, it's very minimal, made out of premium materials, and it has a very functional blade with a hollow grind. That blade is made out of a CPM S35VN. It's about 3.13 inches long. The handle is 4.02 inches long. It has an overall length of 7.15 inches, and it's coming in with a weight of 3.38 ounces. Now, the Impinda is a two-handed opening, non-locking knife. The spring tension on this one comes from the stainless steel backspacer, and everything else on this knife is then titanium, including the 3D milled pocket clip. If you prefer not to use that, you can remove the domed hardware, which Chris Reeves is basically known for, and then you can put a little filler cap in there and just basically drop this thing in the bottom of your pocket or utilize that little lanyard hole. All right, close up time with the Impinda, and I'm immediately gonna draw in this knife right here for a comparison because this is the one that actually got me hooked on Chris Reeves. Of course, we're talking about the Sebenza 21. Now, the 21 has been the flagship of Chris Reeves knives for a while now. I've done a video on this specific knife. This is a Tanto blade with the micarta inlays. I love this thing a lot, and there's a lot to love about it. S35VN blade, titanium, really premium materials. Even something as simple as the domed hardware, which is very easy to remove. These knives are very easy to service. There are so many good things to love about the design of a Chris Reeves Sebenza, and it basically has set the standard for Reeves integral locks all across the knife market. Now, if you take a lot of the things with a Sebenza like this and put them into a slip joint design, then you basically get something like this Impinda right here. Now, you're probably already taking notice to all the little snail trails on the titanium on this thing, especially back here on the pocket clip. I have carried this thing for a little while. I completely stopped carrying any kind of folding knife that has a locking mechanism, and I went completely lockless with a knife like this for probably like 2 weeks or so. It was an interesting experience because, like I mentioned, this thing is designed to be a two-handed opening knife, just like that. You have a nail nick right here, which I personally don't even really use. It's definitely deep enough and functional enough that you can get a nail on there. However, I just basically grab the blade and pull it open. Now, before we get into how this blade actually opens and all of the cool stuff going on inside of here, we'll talk about this titanium a little bit more because this thing is a very premium knife for sure. There's very minimal branding. You have the Chris Reeves logo in there, and then on the inside, you probably can't even see it, but inside right here is Williams' signature. And then I believe on this side it says made in Idaho, just like the Sebenzas do. So other than that, this thing is just super sleek and minimal. It has the really nice domed hardware, even on the pivot, just like the Sebenzas do. And then this pocket clip is really nice. However, if you want to go the more traditional slip joint route, you probably don't like a pocket clip. So you could actually remove that if you so choose. The blade is a shallow hollow grind, and that hollow grind comes all the way up almost to the spine of the blade, so this thing is actually a very good slicer. It has a really cool grind on the top here as well, almost coming to a sharpened point out here at the tip. It's not actually sharp, but it narrows down to a point there, which would be good for piercing. Now, when I think of slip joint knives like this, I don't really think of a hard use knife. However, something like this with really good tolerances and really good material, I actually did use this knife for EDC tasks. I'm not like whittling wood and stuff like that with this knife. However, I think the design is good enough and it feels solid enough that you could use this knife a little bit harder than some other options out there. Now, one thing that's cool about this internal mechanism is that it is not like other slip joint knives. You'll notice that as I close this blade up, for one, there's no half stop. Another thing to note is that this is not going to be as smooth as a Sebenza. This thing is basically like two oiled pieces of glass rubbing up against each other. It's going to be extremely hard to get an action like a Sebenza out of a slip joint knife like this. There is no half stop here, so it's not going to stop as you're closing it. However, it will not actually go all the way closed until way back here at about a 45 degree angle. Even a little bit less than that, actually. So without going into too much detail, basically the way this works is it is like an oval shaped lock in here. When you pull the knife open, there is about 1 pound of resistance to get that thing out. You'll notice the backspacer coming back here. And then once you pull it into its fully locked, although it's not really locked position, that thing is seated there very nicely. It feels like the knife has a lock and it's completely locked open. Now, because of that oval design, when it is open in this position right here, there's actually more resistance, about 5 pounds of resistance to close this knife then. You'll notice right here, this could be dangerous with some other slip joint designs, but I know that this thing is not gonna rocket close on my fingers. Now again, this is not completely smooth like a Sebenza, however, it does have a really good fit and finish to it, and then once you get almost all the way closed, then it will actually snap closed just like that. So really cool design on the Impinda. Now let's bring in some other options so we can talk about the walk and talk of all the knives. And here's one that I thought might be a sort of interesting comparison. We have a Spyderco Delica 4. Very similar in size, even color and almost shape. This, however, is a lockback design, and you'll notice on this one, when I disengage that lock and start pushing this thing closed, right at about the mark where there would be a half stop on a more traditional slip joint knife, this thing is going to start to build up tension and then sort of rocket closed right about there. Now granted, I'm not saying this knife is dangerous at all, because for the most part, when you're disengaging that lock on a lockback design, you're gonna have your hands out of the way when that closes up. So I'd say that these two are sort of similar in the way that they function in and out. Now I'll pull out this really old camp style knife right here. This blade has seen some better days. Right there is a half stop, all the way open. Doesn't really click into place quite as nice as a knife like this, but this thing is probably like 30, 35 years old anyway. It does have that half stop there, which I personally actually like that. You know that that thing is not gonna come slamming down on your fingers. This knife does not have that, but the Impinda also does not do this when you're closing it the rest of the way. Once you get over that detent, it'll like snap close pretty aggressively. You can try to do it slowly. Not the easiest thing to do slowly, but yeah, it's just a sort of different function compared to this. Now, two more knives that would actually make a pretty good comparison would be these two right here. You may have seen these in some previous videos. I also mentioned that I was gonna show you these knives, and these are actually custom Swiss Army knives from Daily Custom. This right here is the Compact. I actually carried this thing for a little while. I tried to do like a Swiss Army knife only carry for a week or so. This too is of course a two-handed opening blade. These things come very, very sharp. And with the modified scales on here, this is also titanium, so it's kind of a cool comparison to put these two up against each other. Swiss Army knife is obviously coming in a lot smaller than the Impinda, but check out the closure on this one. So there's no true half stop here, and then this thing fires closed pretty quickly. Again, I'm not saying that these knives are dangerous, because for the most part, you're gonna be closing this with two hands anyway. Probably close it with one hand, you just gotta be careful of where your fingers are falling. But that will just go as sort of another comparison against the Impinda. And then we have one more. This one is a little bit larger, some more tools on this one. Again, titanium scales from Daily Customs on there. A lot more tools on this. And then the blade on this one is pretty much the same. I found that the quality control on Swiss Army knives is a little bit different from knife to knife, so let's check out the closure on this. This one's a little bit smoother to close, maybe. doesn't fire closed quite as quickly as this one did. But yeah, still a good option. So what would you use a knife like this for? This to me is like the ultimate gentleman's folder. If I'm ever going somewhere dressed up nice and I'm maybe wearing a suit, I want to have a knife in my pocket. This is probably the knife that I'm going to take. I really don't have many slip joints, unless you're including these right here. However, if I want something sort of classy and elegant, dressing up type of knife, this is definitely going to be the one that you would find in my pocket. Certainly not for everyone. I don't believe that Chris Reeves knives are for everyone out there. However, once you really catch the knife bug and you find a love for something like this with that fit and finish and the quality that Chris Reeves supplies, then chances are you might like a knife similar to this. So that's really all that I had for the Chris Reeves Impinda. These knives are typically not my style, but with their modern spin on it, it obviously was good enough that I knew I needed to buy it. And now this one is in my collection box, and I think it will be here for quite a while until maybe I find something else to replace it. I don't think anything's gonna replace this, though. If you guys have any questions on the Impinda, let me know in the comments down below. I will also try to leave links to where you can find these things. Now, with that being said, continue using that hashtag so I can pick some of your photos to be featured in the next video coming out tomorrow at 9 a.m. And if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing because I'm making new videos every single day this week. That's going to be all for today. So as always, thank you guys for watching, and I will talk to you in the next one.